How's it going, viewers? Thank you guys for watching my video. In this video, I'll be doing a review on the Poetic iPad Pro case review. This is the turtle skin case. Just before I get started, I'd like to thank Poetic for letting me do a review on their product. This was in the packaging when it had came when I received it. Thank you for your purchase. About them, poeticcases.com is a place you can check them out. I will also have a link to the actual iPad case, the Amazon link to the iPad case in the description below. So if you guys want to go ahead and check that out, it will be right there at the bottom in the description area. And I'm just going to go ahead and get started here. This case is made out of a rubbery material. As you guys can see, it is very flexible, so to speak. There's no structural support. Once the iPad is in there, it becomes very supported. You can't notice the flimsiness. The one thing I like about this material, it will absorb a good amount of impact. So if you were to drop your iPad, this material will absorb it fairly well. They have a nice design here. They got their name and their logo up here. And one of the things that I had noticed is these corners, how they have the little air pockets there. It's a really great design. If you were to drop your iPad, the material, even though it's rubber and it can move out to the side, still will want to go in if it hits the corner. With this, it will help absorb it. So the material will move forward and into that air pocket. The air will get pushed out and it will still absorb the impact and will not leave that big of a hit. And before I put the case on, I just kind of wanted to look inside here. It's got these nice waves, and what that is made for, what that's designed for, is to catch dust and any kind of small, micro, little tiny things, sand, dust, something that will usually scratch the back of your iPad if you had it in there. If it was just nice and flat, it will scratch it up, but since it has these little bays, little runways, whatever you want to call them, the sand will be in there, and it can, slide around or just sit in there. It won't be pushed up against the iPad as much, and it won't cause that big of a problem. It's more, and it's also like a grip feature to kind of help grip the iPad. One more thing I will want to show you guys is, if you guys can see in there, the iPad does go a good distance into the actual case itself to help kind of hold it once it's in. So that's also something that I found and, kind of figured and put that in a pause on my positive list, just to kind of one of the things that I liked. So I'm going to go ahead and install the iPad into the case. Like I always do, I find the side that has the most amount of buttons, which is this side here. It has the two buttons here. I'm going to go ahead and slide that in first. And with I had mentioned the edges, the iPad goes in far. You might have to push a little bit to get them in, or if you want, you can start by having it out, starting out a little ways. Once you get both sides in, you can at that point just slide it. Once you slide it all the way, you're left with the two corners. Push the two corners in. I got my one corner in. I'll just work this one up to the side. And if you have any kind of material that is pushed, pushed up, folded back, still you can pull that up. So now that I have it installed, I will start with the face here. As you guys can see from the face, clear, there's no screen protector, nothing like that, which is nice. You can touch the screen. I mean, if you scratch the screen, that's kind of your call there. It has a very big lip around the edge, so if the iPad were to fall face down, and if there was something laying there, good chances that this will catch it before it hits concrete or asphalt, something like that, something pokey, rocks. I had mentioned the impact corners. All four corners have the little air pockets to kind of help absorb the impact. And this was a really cool feature that I had noticed and I had liked. This is to redirect the sound. There are four spots where the speakers are on the iPad, and these little pockets here redirect the sound to make it flow towards you. So if you're watching a video, YouTube, Netflix, whatever, you're watching something, all the sound will be coming towards you instead of getting projected out to the side. So cool feature made by Poetic. I like it. I give them a thumbs up for it. Pretty sweet. There's a cutout here for the home button just to make it easily accessible. Next, we will look down on the bottom side. All we have there is a slot, a hole for the charging port. I tried a couple different charging ports. They all seem to fit, so this hole is big enough to fit different types of chargers, or different sizes of chargers, I should say. The next side we have here is the right side with the volume buttons. There's a bit of a texture here to kind of help hold on to the case. And then there's the volume buttons. As you guys can see, it's kind of cut away, so in a way. It's not completely cut out. It's just cut away to kind of help you find the volume up and down button. And the way it's cut out makes it almost feel like you're hitting the actual physical button on the iPad. So moving on to the next side, we have the power button. The power button cut out as well, similar to the volume button here on your side. The next cut out is for your headphone jack, and I tried my headphone jack in there. It does fit. I don't have very many other sizes, so I wasn't able to test that. And then the last side here has, you know, just more grip, just when you're using it to hold on to. And we move to the back side now, and I had mentioned, you know, Poetic, their logo, cool little design they have going here. There is a cutout or a pocket for the Apple Pencil. Go ahead and slide it in there. Pretty cool. There is a cutout for your camera and your microphone. One thing I did notice was the microphone here on the side was either forgotten about or just left out completely. I don't know if that affects it that much, but I did notice there was no cutout for that. And overall, I like the case. I would recommend it to anybody looking for a nice case. One thing that is missing that I would like to have on a case that I own is a little kickstand. So if you're watching a video, you could set it down and you don't have to hold it, or do a little band so you can slide your hand in there and hold the actual case and then use your other hand to, you know, type or search or scroll, whatever, instead of having to hold it or lean it up against something and hold it with one hand. Just makes it a little bit easier, just something you can slide your hand in and kind of just flip over. But other than that, really awesome case. I like it. I'll probably be using it for a while until I get my next review case. But like I said, awesome. If you guys like it, I will have a link in the description below. You guys can go ahead and check that out. If you guys have any comments, questions, go ahead, put them in the comment section below. I will do my best to answer them. And that's all I got for you guys. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.